Decoupage is a fun technique to play with colors, beautiful pattern papers and your decoupage papers, MDF base or any of your base and create something creative. Hi friends, it's Sonia here and let's get started. I have this wooden 6x6 tray which I got recently and I have this beautiful pattern paper. It's basically the decoupage paper from Nakshatra Design and I'm going to use this on my tray and make something preppy. First, I'm going to mark the inner side size on my paper and I'm just marking with dot on a pencil and I'm going to cut along that line to have my perfect square for my tray. Now I'm going to play around with colors and here I have taken yellow color and with my sponge I'm going to dab my colors completely on my tray. So in the center of the tray, I am going to stick my paper so we do not have to color that portion. We will be coloring all the sides, the outer portion, the inner portion and just on the edges of the center. Here for this tutorial I am using sponge piece. You can use any of your paint brushes also or you can use any of your sponge pieces also. This is almost same. With this sponge you do not get any lines which you usually get with any of your brushes and with sponge you get those nice texture. Those are very thin, very smooth but they look really nice. Before starting any of your decoupage work, just make sure that your base is very, very clean. Once you're done with the coloring, always make sure that you put the double coat because it's an MDF, it's kind of a wood and it absorbs color. So you tend to get a patchy work in first go. So there is no harm in anyways having two coats. So this is how my tray looks after my complete coloring and now it's time to stick my pattern paper. So here I'm using my matte finish Mod Podge and I'm going to spread it completely on my base where I'm going to stick my paper. So for spreading this I'm using my thick flat brush and I'm going to evenly spread out my adhesive. Once the adhesive is done, now I'm going to stick my paper. Just make sure that you stick it properly, press it properly so that you do not have any bubbles or anything in the center. Once the paper sticking is done, then you can apply again a coat of Mod Podge and spread your paper very evenly. You can use your again a sponge piece or your fat brush, anything in which you are comfortable with. Once my Mod Podge is dried out completely, it's time to add some festive color to it. So here I'm using my pink shimmer paint and I totally adore them. You must have seen in almost all my videos that I use them. And I'm just going to color the handles first with my brush. Coloring handle is a little tricky part, but it's really fun, and once the color is dried out completely, then we'll go to the next step. Now I have taken some of the color on my lid and I'm going to add some water to it, and now with my another sponge piece I am going to dab the colors on the borders. So this is a really fun way of adding some shimmer to it. I don't want to have very bold shimmery look cause my beautiful decoupage paper is very preppy and has some very pop out color. So this is just to complement that. First, I'll be doing one layer of my shimmer paint coat, and then I'll going to repeat the same step again on the same side so that I get a really nice poppy shimmer color. Now, once my paint, my decoupage paper, everything has dried out completely, it's time to add our final coat to it. So here I'm using my Mod Podge. You need to apply a very thick coat of Mod Podge. Once your Mod Podge has dried out completely, you can use your any of the sealer spray or your varnish to do the project, and your decoupage trays are ready. This was my take on decoupage with Nakshatra Designs decoupage papers, and I have done one more video tutorial with altering my old tray. Do check that too. I have listed all the supplies used in this video below in the description box. Do check that. And if you have any query, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you all. Thank you so much for watching.